Warning, this show is not a regular KSHS newscast. Some of the facts you hear, well, they're just not factual. When the sports appear, that's real.
What's the matter, Tex?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing?
Well, now that Tex is over, I don't have a job anymore. Everybody already took me in.
Why don't you go look for one?
Because I can't hold a job longer than a week.
Well, it's okay. Come with me.
Hi, this is my buddy Tex. He's been working so hard lately, he's in need of relief. So the seniors at KSHS have decided to put on a tax relief show for the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors. While you tested, we rested.
Live from the state-of-the-art KSHS Broadcast Center in the Rio Grande Valley, you're watching World Update with your host, Keisha Topangan.
There's a national effort to get people to learn the lyrics of the national anthem. One organization, the National Anthem Project, targets mostly teachers who teach in all grade levels to help students learn how to sing and remember the Star-Spangled Banner.
National Anthem. Oh, say, can you sing it?
Can you sing it?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Thank you.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming?
Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous light?
Empire to you watch, we're so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare.
The bombs bursting in air gave proof to the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
What was it?
Or the land of the free.
Or the land of the free.
The national anthem was written by Francis Scott Key during the War of 1812. Please rise for the singing of the national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight? O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, their bombs bursting in air, gave proof to the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled
other news, a recent study found that too many Americans were over-medicated. When asked what they thought about the results, they simply replied with... Now, welcome to the studio, an employee from the Coca-Cola factory.
A few weeks ago, I lost my teeth while I was drinking a nice cold, delicious bottle of Coca-Cola. I want them back, so I'm asking you, if anyone out there has found them, please return them to me. I tell you what, they're very, very important to me because they're very old and I need them to chew my teeth.
Thank you. And now for a public service announcement.
More inflatable games. The sumo wrestling was such a big hit last year that we decided to do that again, as well as add more inflatable games. We have a full casino with craps tables, blackjack, Texas Hold'em. We've added Texas Hold'em this year for the first time because it's such a big thing around town now. The kids really like to play it. Also, we have hoop shoots. We have a tattoo parlor. You can have your picture taken with your friends. There's all-you-can-eat food. There's usually pizza, hamburgers, hot dogs, drinks, cake, cookies, hot wings. Winning money. There's so many different ways to win money. You just have to be there at 2 o'clock in the morning, and they start pulling out names out of a bin. And three students are going to win $1,000, and three are going to win $500 cash. Also, you can win money with a raffle. For every package of tickets that are sold, the student goes in the money machine one time. It'll be immediately after the graduation at the Casa del Sol. It starts around 10. And it will go on to about 2:30 or 3 a.m. We're expecting a larger crowd this year than last year. And so everybody come out and enjoy yourself.
4L. Macaroni. Some say it is just a side dish. Others say it is the other white meat. And still, others say that it is just plain delicious. But the world today focuses on problems such as obesity, people getting fat, and people eating too much, when the real problem is macaroni deficiency.
This year, the FDA issued a new food pyramid that only a few people know about. As you can see, macaroni is at the bottom, and it is recommended that one consumes at least 1 to 1,000 servings per day. The FDA also recommends 3 to 7.5 servings of egg roll per day, 2 cucumbers, and a maximum of 1 serving of bologna per day.
When you sit down to enjoy your meal, do you think, am I getting enough macaroni? We asked a few South students if they felt they were getting enough.
Are you getting your recommended servings of macaroni daily?
No, I'm not.
Could you please explain why?
Because they serve beans, not macaroni.
Do you get the recommended serving of macaroni daily?
Not from this school, because at this school they put pepper in it. And guess what? I'm allergic to pepper. Pepper makes me sneeze. Go to Louis, love it. Mm, yep.
Here is the testimony of a former member of the Federal High School Food Association. His identity has been concealed to protect the innocent.
I worked for the Federal High School Food Association for 5 years. During my time at the FHSFA, I took part in macaroni rationing. A serving of macaroni should have 70 to 80 noodles. Despite this, most students are only given about 37 noodles. When I tried to inform the FDA about this, I was fired.
To help cure this epidemic, make sure you and your children obey the food pyramid.
Macaroni, I love you. You're my little macaroni lady. This is a macaroni montage. A macaroni montage, yeah. Macaroni, so noodly.
Now that's where you eat fruits and vegetables.
just in. The Cookie Monster has broken his new diet by going on a massive cookie binge. He was found lying in a gutter surrounded by empty boxes of Chips Ahoy. Our hearts go out to him as he recently has been entered into the Cookie Rehab. A reality show spinoff is currently in the works, which features Cookie Monster's transition back to normal life on Sesame Street.
December 23rd, 2000. Seemed like any other day for Juan Ramirez Henderson Alvarez de Leon Perez. Received a package addressed to him from a close friend on his front doorstep. He picked it up, walked inside, and placed it on his kitchen table.
I put the box down, and so I turn around, and I get a glass so I can get some tang. And I heard a noise coming from the box, and I open the box, and I see a gnome with bubble wrap. Well, I thought nothing of it, so I just turn around, and I drink my tang, and I felt a pop on my back, and I knocked out. And I woke up 3 days later, and I don't know.
Juan's attacker was none other than the silent but deadly new epidemic, bubble wrap. Sure, may seem harmless at first. It's even a popular method used to ship fragile items. People even give it to their kids to play with. But turn your back on it, and it will turn into a battle for your life.
Being attacked, how'd it make you feel?
Well, I lost my dignity. I lost my privacy. I can't even go into the garage anymore because of all the boxes. And you know, the worst of them all, que me quitaron mi tang. I went to Walmart, y estaban sold out. Estaban gone, there's no more. Quiero mi tang.
Juan, you started the Bubble Wrap Attack Intelligence Investigation Agency and Bureau of North America, correct?
Well, I wanted to start an organization because I got attacked, and I don't want anyone else to get attacked, so you can get support from everyone else, too. And while I'm here, anyone have tang? Have Tutti Frutti tang? I need it. That's sold out. Tang.
If you or a family member are in a situation involving bubble wrap, immediately find a phone and call 1-800-POP-RAP or visit the website at www.bwiiabna.org. Thank you, and stay safe.
And now, it's time for Deep Thoughts with Jack Handy.
You can't go with the crowd all the time, just doing what everybody else is doing. I mean, if all your friends were named Cliff, would you just jump off of them?
Recently, a video was found which featured the famed band Blue Oyster Cult in the studio. Let's take a look.
Whoa, I can't believe it. It's Bruce Dickinson. Easy, fellas. I put my pants on just like the rest of you. One leg at a time. The only difference is, once my pants are on, I make gold records. All right, so let's take it from the top. Let's roll.
Bruce, can you come back in here for a minute?
Hey, fellas, what's the deal? That was me a great track.
Are you sure that was sounding okay?
It was sounding great, but to tell you the truth, I wanted more cowbell, though. Gene, this time, I want you to really explore the space. I mean, really explore the space. Take it again. Take two. Let's roll. Two great tracks. What's going on? What's wrong?
Seems Gene's cowbell playing is a bit distracting.
Well, you guys know I could cut back a little if,
Not too much, though. I'm telling you guys, you're gonna want to hear that cowbell on the track. Let's try it again. Let's go. Roll.
I'm standing here looking at Bruce Dickinson. And if Bruce Dickinson wants more cowbell, we should probably give him more cowbell.
Guess what? I got a fever. And the only prescription is more cowbell.
What does that mean?
Never question Bruce Dickinson. Let's take it again from the top.
Ago, a would-be robber was arrested in Great Britain after being hit over the head with a garden gnome while trying to break into Jean Callop's house. Let's hear what she has to say.
I saw the intruder in my front lawn. I told him not to move. So I grabbed the first thing that came to hand, one of my garden gnomes, and I hurled it at him.
Thank you, Miss Callop. Everyone has heard about the finger that was found in the Wendy's chili. Investigators are trying to figure out who it belongs to, but they can't quite put their finger on it. We'll be back after this.
Do you carry any those Diesel branded jeans?
Yeah, I also carry pre-1995 J-Lo albums. Would you like me to wrap that up with the last season of Survivor for you?
Or you might want to try that time machine over there. Set it for, 1994.
Come on, Matt. Diesel's a hit.
Yeah, a hit that should be replaced. That's rude. Look, this is Jeffrey's, okay? The highest size we carry here is zero, so unless you're on a steady diet of celery or Nexlax, don't even think about shopping here.
Now, why don't you eat the ice cream you wanted? You know you want one.
I hate this. That was toxic.
Yeah.
Excuse me, do y'all carry any DKNY?
We're the ones that should be asking DKNY you're wasting your time. Leave.
Leave now.
I just don't recognize any of the labels in the store.
Look, Pepper, this is Jeffrey's. Even our labels have their own labels. This Ferragamo label is made by Armani.
Yeah, this is Jeffrey's. I use 5 different shampoos for the different types of hair on my body.
Too bad they don't make personal velvet ropes you can tie around yourself.
Seriously.
Can you just help me?
No, no.
But I was just looking
No,
for... no. But I was just...
No, no.
But I...
No, no.
But...
No!
Please, I just need a little bit of your help.
No, look, see, I work at Jeffrey's. I use Moroccan dental floss. It's more expensive than your entire wardrobe.
What? This is a genuine Abercrombie shirt.
I didn't know my next-door neighbor's 13-year-old daughter was having a garage sale. You might want to check back with us during Christmas time. Maybe donate to the homeless.
See you then.
Hey, guys. Hold on. Hello? Awesome! Fantastic! We'll be there! How fast can y'all pack your bags to the Louis Vuitton show in Paris?
I got my text made back, already packed.
My Paul Smith towed to St. Tower, voila!
I'm ready for the Concorde, let's go!
I wish they had something higher than first class.
Please.
Does your back constantly itch, and you can't reach it? And there's no one around to help? If so, use our cream. Full effect, takes 4 hours.
This just in, 92% of the freshmen forgot to answer the art portion of the tax exam. Space has been made for next year's schedule for mandatory tax prep classes.
My name is Tom Schiller. I don't have a date for the prom because nobody likes me. I like long walks on the beach. I like to read a nice book while curled up next to the fire. And I really would like someone to go to the prom with me. I can't talk anymore.
Hi, my name's Cruz. I'm 6 feet, hazel eyes, brown hair. Well, I can't really say I enjoy long walks on the beach because I have asthma. Thus, I have to take short walks because if I take really long ones, I'll have an asthma attack. So if you like to take short walks too, and you like someone that has a hazel eyes, contact me, please.
I want to go to the prom, but no one will go with me. I need some. My name's Sam. Yeah, Sam. I have Tang if you want to go, because I got new Tang. Tang?
Good evening, ladies. My name is Reginald Winston Goat III, and I am looking for a nice lady to accompany me to the prom. I enjoy playing polo with my friends at the country club. And I enjoy playing tennis and competitive ping pong. And I also fence every once in a while when I feel a little outrageous. So, if you want to go with a sophisticated type to this little shindig we call the senior prom, give me a call. Thank you. And now, it's time for Deep Thoughts with Jack Handy.
One time, I was thinking about, what if pigs could fly? But then, I didn't know if there would be enough room for pigs and birds to fly. And if there was, if we wanted bacon, how would we kill the pigs?